Hello, brothers and sisters in Christ. Today is Sunday, August the 9th, and it's 10:30 a.m. And I've been saving this little story to share. I just thought it was something worth mentioning because this could come to more cities than Los Angeles. It was put up on August the 6th. So how old is that? 3 days ago. All right, it is from Natural News, and the title is Los Angeles to Cut Off Water and Electricity for Private Homes That Disobey Lockdown Rules. Can anybody say communist? I mean, are you kidding me? I understand a fine, not $10,000. In New York, they're fining people $10,000 for not obeying their rules up there. I mean, they've got roadblocks going. I believe I mentioned that the other day. Well, now I think it's gotten worse. But anyway, let me read this a little bit anyway. We have now entered the era of state-sponsored COVID terrorism, where the government declares war on private citizens and destroys their homes if they disobey increasingly draconian lockdown rules. The mayor of Los Angeles just announced that water and electricity will be cut off from homes that disobey. This is nuts, y'all. It is so nuts. This means private homes and businesses will be turned into sweltering black mold petri dishes. Thanks to government action, and there's no recourse because the entire action is being pursued completely outside the rule of law. How did they get away with that? This is raw tyranny and government terrorism. It has now arrived at your doorstep in L.A. Why don't they just put them in jail for 10 days? I mean, what would be a fair punishment? Because let me just keep reading. This is raw tyranny and government terrorism. It has now arrived at your doorstep. All right, see the full story here. Let me click on that. All right, now it says state-sponsored COVID terrorism. Los Angeles threatens to cut off electricity and water of private homes that refuse to comply with authoritarian lockdown rules. Okay, now it shows a guy. Looks like he's looking through the bar like as if he's got two... I don't know if they're window panes, but it makes out like it's jail, you know, and he's sticking his head out. Anyway, and it says on his door, pandemic COVID-19 quarantine. All right, Natural News. In the latest escalation of state-sponsored COVID-19 terrorism against innocent citizens, Los Angeles Mayor Garcetti is now threatening to shut off the water and electricity to private homes and businesses that don't comply with his increasingly draconian lockdown rules. This threat is, of course, a form of state-sponsored terrorism against citizens. Cutting off electricity from a private home in the middle of Southern California heat wave is the equivalent of condemning the targeted family to death via heat exhaustion. Now that's the truth. You can't even run a fan without power. Cutting off electricity also causes refrigerators and freezers to fail, destroying the home food supply of that same family. Lack of air conditioning also results in the near instant growth of black mold, an indoor chemical contaminant that leads to severe fatigue and even death. This destroys the value of the home and makes it nearly impossible to sell. Now that you add all that up, value-wise, what's a life worth? Is it worth it if a person in that home, because say the dad has been tested positive, so the whole family's under quarantine now. They got this quarantine sign on their door. See, I don't know if that would be enough to put that there, or if the whole family, I would think it'd be one person in the family. Maybe it says later on. But to cut off, if they're caught like walking the dog or taking out the trash, I mean, seriously, do they expect you to pile up trash for how long? Is it 2 weeks? It might be 4 weeks. I'm not sure. Let me just read on. This is just disgusting. They really want to throw a threat out there, so you be sure to not leave your house, because, oh my, you might give it to somebody who might give it to somebody else who might give it to somebody else. And yeah, we don't want to do that. But really, walking your dog, say, late at night when no one's around, because you need to get out, or taking your trash out? I mean, I don't know what inside means inside. Anyway, with this threat to shut off electricity and water, the city of Los Angeles is essentially engaged in acts of war against its own citizens over COVID-19 lockdown rules. Those who refuse to comply with the draconian demands of an obviously insane mayor will be placed on an enemies list and have city services shut off. Beginning Friday night, so I guess that would be this past Friday, if Los Angeles Police Department officers respond to and verify that a large party is occurring at a property, and there's evidence that the venue has repeatedly engaged in such behavior, the department will request that the city shut off water and power services within 48 hours. Reports the LA Times. Well, now that is a little different, isn't it? If the rules are you have to stay 6 feet apart, and you got a large party in a home because you just want to, even though we all know, you know what this is, a plandemic, and it's no more than the annual flu. It's just a power thing to bring in a new world order. We know that. And if a family knows that and they go ahead and have a big party, break the law, well, they deserve some kind. I'd say fine them. But to do that, especially if there's children in that home, what if they decided to have a big birthday party because their dad turned 65? Or their grandpa lives with them and he just turned 80 and it could be his last birthday. I mean, they don't care about the reason. They probably don't even check to see, are they all wearing masks? Are they doing any kind of social distancing? Probably not, if it's a private party. What would be the proper punishment? I mean, here, if someone turns 80 or 90 or 100, it doesn't matter. If they're on the second or third floor, they can only see their loved ones through the window. I mean, they don't care that it's a special event. They don't care. They don't want anybody bringing the virus in to the most vulnerable of the nation, which is the elderly. And like that one lady said that I reported on that two-minute video from Judy Mikovits, no elderly person should ever take a vaccine. And who are the ones they push it on the most? The elderly. Anyway, so they say if they have a party, the department will request that the city shut off water and power services within 48 hours, repeats the LA Times. Dear Lord, help us. No due process, no rule of law, no recourse, no appeal, just full-blown government tyranny. The problem with this aggressive action is that it is being conducted outside any due process. And that is a problem. No court hearing, no right to any defense, no right to appeal. It's simply the government acting like tyrannical militants who are declaring war on the private homes and businesses they don't like. Yet how many times have LA police conducted no-knock raids on the wrong homes? No-knock. In other words, they bust the door in because someone gave them an address and had the number wrong. Bureaucrats are stupid and corrupt. Okay, that's this guy's opinion. They get home addresses wrong all the time. And why is that? What happens when they cut off the water and power to the wrong private home or business? Because this is taking place completely outside the rule of law. There's no recourse for those who are innocently harmed. I can see that happening. If they'll bust in a door without triple checking the address, making sure it's the right place, they could do it with this, turning off their power and their water. And no recourse. Oh my goodness, this is terrible. And who decides what constitutes a large gathering in the first place? In the minds of twisted, irrational leftists, a three-person gang shooting is counted as a mass shooting. Does that mean a gathering of just three people will be condemned as a large party? It's quite clear that the LA mayor is simply going to make this up as he goes along, which means private homes owned by Republicans or Trump supporters might be magically condemned as hosting large gatherings, even when they aren't. Just as the First Amendment has now been stripped away from conservatives, can't go to church. If they do allow church, you still have to have your social distancing and no singing. All right, just as the First Amendment is, has now been, okay, that's a typo. Just as the First Amendment has now been stripped away from conservatives in Los Angeles, the right to have access to electricity and water may soon be limited only to those who support Democrats. Lord Jesus, come quickly. We are watching this nation plunge into medical fascism and even state-sponsored terrorism, mostly at the hands of Democrat mayors and governors who seem to be relishing their newfound powers to punish all those who don't comply with each day's new COVID insanity. What's next? Forced demolition of private homes that don't comply? Let's read this. Before long, Los Angeles will probably, this is his opinion, start ordering the demolition of private homes and businesses that refuse to comply. Oh, wait, that's already the case in the UK. The UK. We and them are like alike. We came from there, you know, where local councils have just been granted the power to seize and demolish private buildings that are deemed to be contaminated. Contaminated. That's in quotes. As Breitbart.com now reports, this is in italics, the Department of Health and Social Care's COVID-19 contain framework, that's in quotes, COVID-19 contain framework, laid out a series of laws, including the Coronavirus Act of 2020, to impose restrictions or requirements to close contaminated premises close to public spaces in the area of the local authority, detain a conveyance or movable structure, detain a conveyance or movable structure. That sounds like a truck or something, right? Disinfect or decontaminate premises, or order a building, conveyance, or structure to be destroyed. Unquote. So now, governments can cut off your electricity, shut off your water, and even demolish your private home if you don't comply. Well, that's in the UK. But see, when it starts in one place, seems how everybody's under the authority of the elite, the Illuminati, the New World Order, it could spread to everybody else. And the lockdowns are only getting more insane by the day, too. Completely without any real effort to solve the pandemic by recommending nutrition and hydroxychloroquine as preventive measures. Yeah, that one doctor was talking about taking one tablet, one pill, whatever, every 2 weeks as a preventive measure. And I did see that, what's his name, the Fullerton Informer, the title was hydroxychloroquine is it's a hoax because the whole virus thing is a hoax. The doctors coming out saying hydroxychloroquine is the treatment. And then they pull their video after millions of views. They make sure plenty have seen it. And then they pull it so they'll think it's true, which further causes everybody to believe this whole thing is for real. You see, and you try to tell somebody it's not what you think it is. I don't know what is people are catching, unless it's got to be the annual flu or they're getting a bad cold. They go to the doctor. Oh, yeah, you tested positive. Some people, they just suffer it out at home and they get fine, like a cold or bronchitis or the annual flu. How many people go to the hospital for a flu every year? Probably only 10%. I don't know what the statistics are, but a lot of people just suffer it out at home. They stay in bed, they drink fluids, they eat chicken soup, they have cough drops, cough syrup, NyQuil, whatever over the counter they can get, and maybe their doctor prescribes them something, and they stay at home and get over it. Well, that, a lot of that's going on with this COVID. So if it's so awful bad, how come the hospitals weren't overwhelmed with it? And now all of a sudden, supposedly, in certain areas, they are. Now what is that all about? We need boots on the ground, somebody within to go find out. These areas that have supposedly full capacity or 90% capacity now because of the coronavirus. Really? I'd really like to know if that's true. Or do they just have a whole lot of flu and they're calling it COVID? So you'd never find that out. All right. We have now arrived at the point where the left-wing government is your true enemy. And they will kidnap you under quarantine laws, forcibly vaccinate you with an untested experimental vaccine, blah, blah, blah. I'm not reading anymore. All right, I'm going to go to the scriptures now and read something to encourage you, which I have read before. But maybe some of you are new and maybe you forgot. Oh, I want a different version. Whoops. Okay. The Reign of the Lord's Anointed is what it's titled. Psalm 2. And it, Act 4:23-31. Oh, this is a reference, Acts 4:23-31. When they had been released, they went to their own companions and reported all that the chief priests and the elders had said to them. And when they heard this, they lifted their voices to God with one accord and said, O Lord, it is you who made the heaven and the earth and the sea and all that is in them, who by the Holy Spirit through the mouth of our father David your servant said, why did the Gentiles rage and the peoples devise futile things? The kings of the earth took their stand. Hold on a minute. Disappeared there. And the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. For truly in this city there were gathered together against your holy servant Jesus, whom you appointed, both Herod and Pontius Pilate, along with the Gentiles and the peoples of Israel, to do whatever your hand and your purpose predestined to occur. And now, Lord, take note of their threats and grant that your bond servants may speak your word with all confidence. It says more. Oh, and it takes you to Acts. Okay, well, I want to read Psalm 2. That was just a reference they give. I don't remember that them ever doing that before. That may be something new they put in. All right, Psalm 2, verse 1. Why are the nations in an uproar and the peoples devising a vain thing? Who are the peoples devising a vain thing? I say that's the powers that be, and it's put the nations in an uproar. Verse 2. The kings of the earth take their stand, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us tear their fetters apart and cast away their cords from us. But verse 4 says, he who sits in the heavens laughs. The Lord scoffs at them. Then he will speak to them in his anger and terrify them in his fury, saying, but as for me, I have installed my king, that would be Jesus, upon Zion, my holy mountain. I will surely tell of the decree of the Lord. He said to me, you are my son. Today I have begotten you. He said to me, this is a capital M, so that's, he's talking to Jesus. You are my son. Today I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will surely give the nations as your inheritance, and the very ends of the earth as your possession. You shall break them with a rod of iron. You shall shatter them like earthenware. They think they're going to rule this world. They got another thing coming. Satan is so stupid. He knows the word better than we do. You know that? He's smart. He's probably got the highest IQ anybody could have. Probably higher than any human. He could probably read a book like this, you know, page after page after page, and know it and remember it. He knows this, but yet he wants to take down as many people as he can. Well, let's not let him. Let's not let him have us or anybody we know. How do we do that? By praying for them. Praying, fasting if they're really bad. Just praying for them. If you've already told them the gospel, maybe a few times, and you've given them a Bible, and you've given them tracts, and you've brought it up at parties, and they've said, I don't want to hear it, then you don't say another word. All you can do is pray. And there's something the Israelites did back in the Old Testament that our pastor had us to do. He had a pile of shoes in the front of the church. Okay, we're all coming into church, and there's a pile of old shoes. Like, they must have went to all the thrift stores and bought up all the old shoes. Not the nice ones, but the older ones that they could, you know. They had enough money to buy them all. Anyway, they had like 300 shoes up front. This must have been a Wednesday night. And he taught about this thing the Hebrews did. When they claimed someone or something, they would take their shoe off and throw it over the item or person to claim that person for the Lord. And one night, I took one of them shoes, and I guess my husband must not have been with me. He might have been working nights or like out of town then. I'm not real sure why, because he was so on fire and he used to go all the time. And then he took that job as an iron worker and he started traveling and got away from it. You know, the world takes you away. It's the worst mistake he ever made, and I even suggested it, and I wished I hadn't. But anyway, I got me one of them shoes, and the first time I could, when he was sound asleep, I took that shoe, and I threw it over the bed, and it hit, and he kind of moved like, you know, but it didn't wake him up, and I claimed him for the Lord. Well, he got saved, but he ended up, I don't know if he's with the Lord or not, but anyway, that was just something they did. And so, see, the things they did in the Old Testament, now we have the blood of Jesus. We have a whole different line of warfare, weaponry, you could say. We've got the Holy Spirit, and we've got the blood of Jesus. So we don't need to be throwing shoes over people, because that was just symbolic of, I don't know, the shoes. I don't remember the symbolism for the shoe. I can't remember. But anyway, I'll move on. Psalm 2, verse 10. Now therefore, O kings, show discernment. Take warning, O judges of the earth. Worship the Lord with reverence and joy. Rejoice with trembling. Do homage to the Son, that he not become angry and you perish in the way. For his wrath may soon be kindled. How blessed are all who take refuge in him. And that's the end of it. So you be encouraged. No matter what they're trying to do, I would suggest you that we all obey the laws to the best of our ability. Now, I know about the mask deal, and there's something in the, I saw a video, someone sent it to me, about how masks are part of a satanic ritual. Well, you know, they do a lot of things in satanic rituals that we do anyway, like light candles. Surgeons and surgical nurses and anyone working in an operating field have to wear a mask, and they do not do it for Satan. You can't think that wearing a mask is taking part in a satanic ritual, because it's not. They might be trying to make you wear a mask for that reason, but you're not doing it for that reason. You're doing it to be obedient to the law, because that's what the Lord says we need to do. Except when it comes to doing something that goes against his will. See, we can't take everything that Satan and his minions have twisted, turned upside down, to turn it into something bad, when it's meant to be something good to the average nurse, doctor even, that hasn't done the research. They just graduated from their Jesuit-run medical school. The nurses graduated from the Jesuit-run nursing school, and all they know is these things will help you to not get sick or make somebody else sick. It's not worth, it is not worth getting a fine for. It is not worth losing your peace over. I wear mine just to get out the door, past the person at the desk, and when I get outside, I take that thing off. I can't stand to wear them, but I don't want to cause other people fear, people that aren't where we're at, and they get all bent out of shape if you don't have your mask on. Well, you know, rather than cause a quarrel, I just put it on. So, you take that to the Lord. If you just think you just cannot wear a mask because it's part of a satanic ritual, take it to the Lord and pray about it. And seriously, think about what I said. Is it worth causing a quarrel over when we're supposed to be wearing the armor and the we put on the shoes of peace? We want to remain in peace and not cause someone to not have peace because we're not wearing a mask because someone said it was part of a satanic ritual. We're not part of a satanic ritual. We belong to Jesus, and we don't do it for that reason. And then this has gone on long enough, so I will put the link to this Natural News article if you want to go over it and read it. It was written by Mike Adams, Thursday, August 6th, state-sponsored COVID terrorism, and it is on Natural News, which is at naturalnews.com, if you cannot read the description box. Okay, with that, I'm going to say I plead the blood of Jesus over this video, the internet connection, myself, my computer, and over each and every single one of you and your devices. And let's see, you, your device, and your internet connections, okay, so that you can stay connected. And remember, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We got to remember that. And our God reigns, and we're going home soon. I pray that each and every single one of you will be found worthy to escape all these things that are to come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. Let's all be found worthy, brothers and sisters. Keep repenting. Keep trying and know that our Lord loves us and He is so merciful, but He does require our obedience. All right, bye for now. I'll talk to you later.